Hi, I'm going to walk you through a little bit on applying an overlay to the pinball playfield. So a little bit on the preparation. I've gone through and sanded the art off of this entirely. I just kind of hit it with the belt sander, 80 grit, just to take it off pretty quickly. You can see there's a few areas where I actually applied Bondo. This playfield was delaminating quite a bit, so I cut out those sections, bonded them, and then sanded them all down. After sanding everything, just apply a light clear coat across everything. That way it seals it in, gives it a nice surface, and it'll kind of remove all the scratches on your inserts. If you have any inserts that you need to level, you want to do that before applying your overlay. The sanding process will take them down a little bit, so if they're just a little off, you don't really have to worry about it. Your belt sander will probably flatten those out for you. But if they're really far off, you want to level them and then hit them with a little super glue. That way they stay put. So after doing all of that prep work, I cut out the overlay, just trimmed it down. That way it's pretty close to the edge, you know, left about an inch to a half inch all the way around. Take my time, and I want to register it really, really well while I have, you know, before I start applying it. So it's kind of can be tricky. Usually you have to give a little bit one way or another. I haven't had one where it lines up super perfect, so, you know, you just kind of pick your points of where you want things to line up the best. You can see here a little bit of registration issues at the top, but almost everything else is lining right up. You know, like my inserts are all really close. And you can see just shifting it a little bit can make a big difference. So once you have it set, you wanna take a piece of tape, or actually I use the overlay material itself. I cut off a strip, and I don't wanna put it on the printed area, but just on the other clear section. I've taped it down. That way I can move this and it'll land right back into position, and I know that I'm lined up. So the idea here is you're just gonna basically do half of it at a time. So I'm gonna start with the bottom. I'm gonna peel back this bottom section, cut it, and then slowly apply this section, and then I'll undo this tape up top and go the other direction. So let's go ahead and start here. It can be kind of tricky to separate these. So the material is a little bit elastic. You don't want to yank on it too much, otherwise you could stretch it and distort where everything is landing up. So when I'm doing this, I'm basically just trying to keep the section taut and slowly apply it like a printer. So I'm pushing down and rubbing back and forth. Little by little. And you want to be sure that the surface is nice and clean, there's no debris underneath there, and that you're not getting any air bubbles underneath there. So that's the whole point of going back and forth real slow. If you do happen to make a mistake, you can pull it back and reset yourself. So now that I got that section down, I'm gonna untape this side, fold it back, and you can see that that plastic just kind of sets itself free. Slowly pull back a little bit. Work my way the other way. I should have pulled that tape off. That easy. That was kind of a quick application. You can go quite a bit slower than that. I've done this a few times, so probably a little less nervous about doing it. It's still a little nerve-wracking. You definitely don't want to mess up. But on this one, this overlay hasn't been die-cut, so all of the inserts, or not the inserts, but the light sockets and switch holes and the holes for the posts will all need to be cut out, trimmed out with an X-Acto knife. It can be a pretty tedious process. I just go through and you can kind of reveal the hole by pushing on it a little bit and then run the X-Acto knife through there. I'll do a little bit. So you can see that this is a spot here. I just poke it. I was using this blade for something else. It's not very sharp anymore, but essentially that's the process. And you go through and you trim everything out, and you want to trim off all the excess that isn't part of the image. And then afterwards, because this isn't one that has a protective coating on it, you'd want to clear coat it. I use a two-part automotive style clear coat. You just need something on there to help protect it. Yeah. I think that's it. Bye.